this on? Ah, now it is. Okay, great. Welcome back. It's great to see such a good crowd. I have a couple of announcements. I've brought them in paper tonight because last night I forgot one. First thing, please come tomorrow morning at 9 o'clock to the membership meeting if you're an ASSA member. We would love to have you all there. We've got a lot of territory to cover and a lot of new exciting things to announce, so I hope you all be there. Tomorrow, the vendors close at 1 o'clock. So if you want to shop, you're going to have to shop before 1 o'clock. They're closing a little bit early so they can get their gear together to return back. What I forgot last night, and I'm not going to forget tonight, is that there is another nightcap jazz performance in the lobby out back right after this concert, so please stick around. And I would like to give a big thank you to this evening's platinum vendor, Dario.
Thank you. Thank you. Good evening. Thank you so much for being here. What a beautifully organized event, impressive in size, hospitality, beautiful venue. It's such an honor to be here. I have a couple things to share with you about Gradient 2.0 this evening. But before I do, I'd like to introduce to you the University of Illinois Percussion Ensemble under the directorship of Professor William Moersch. From left to right, we have Dan Benson. Trent Shuey. John Jaworski. Yishuan Lin. And Colin Rambert. Their impressive ensemble has really devoted a lot of great time and talent to this piece, so I'm grateful for that. So, Gradient 2.0 is composed by Baljinder Sekhon. He and I met while in school at the Eastman School of Music, and there's two things I'd like to share with you about him and the piece. One is that Baljinder loves noise. He loves noise like one might love melody or harmony, and he finds melody and harmony in noises, and he blends them together like we would blend notes in a chord in chamber music in interesting combinations. So that's actually where the title of the piece comes from. Originally, it was composed for alto saxophone and prepared piano, and Gradient refers to his attempt to cross the gap, the gradient between the two instruments, using the noisier elements of their sonic capabilities. The second thing I'd like to share with you is Baljinder's interest in process. So one of his teachers is David Lang, who you may be familiar with for his piece Press Release for bass clarinet, often stolen by us on the baritone saxophone. And Press Release is a process-driven work. There's an idea that unfolds and sort of allows the piece to compose a lot of itself. So Baljinder spent many months organizing the process behind Gradient, which is built purely on a rhythmic cycle. So the distance between the rhythms cycles mathematically, goes through all its various permutations, like shifting a prism, and then all those results are mapped onto the pitch. So you have a perfect relationship between time and pitch in this piece. And I just find that so fascinating. We were in a class where he wrote a paper on the same effect in Bartok's music while he was writing this piece. So I love it, and I hope you do too. This is Gradient 2.0.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much. We are the Monin Frogs, and you just heard us perform Smiles and Chuckles, which was a very common piece performed by the six Brown brothers, and now we're going to continue our portion of this concert with our Michigan Rags Suite. Thank you very much. Thank you.
concert. Thank you for having us, Debra and Michael. It's been a great pleasure and also a huge honor for us to share this stage with everyone. The next piece that you're about to hear is composed by Ted Goldman, who is actually a theory professor at the Eastman School of Music. And the title, Rhymes with Silver, actually is an imaginary band. And if you can imagine the band Rhymes with Silver trying to record an album, and it will be, you know, you'll be hearing four movements of it, but they're not really just tracks 1, 2, 3, and 4, it'll be like 1, 3, 7, 13, something like that. And so they are totally disjunct, and but I do need to go through every single movement with you so you have something to listen for. Now the first movement is called photorespiration. Now, I don't really know what it means either, but he, at some point, was in the same boat. And so it was during, I think it was 8th grade biology class, he had this name, this term in his head that he couldn't, he was trying to memorize it and see what the meaning is of it was. And the whole time through this, he had this motif in his mind, and it was finally when he wrote this piece that he was able to put this little da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da, put it down on paper. And then the second movement, what's the second movement?
Assembly.
It's called Assembly. Now, Assembly actually starts off like the train, okay? Now, you will have like very little parts coming together and they don't quite seem to fit and they are very, very weird sounding. But at some point, the whole thing starts to grind and finally comes together and it will start to groove, okay? And so that's how things assemble. And the third movement is called Prelude, purposely spelled with two A's. And it starts off like a Bach prelude, and very serene, like just really like Bach, and then one by one the players come in and they start to play really weird Bach. And so finally you have like many, many preludes going on at the same time, and it's just too much. That's how it should sound like. And then the final movement is called WSAX, which is really like a radio show. And Ted wanted us to imagine that we are falling asleep with the radio tune on, and you will start to drift and you start to realize that, well, I'm listening to this, but after a while, I seem to be listening to another channel. So it's many, many things coming together. I hope you enjoy this. I present to you ESP.
Thank you. Thank you. I'm gonna play my life for one of the